Hey everyone, this is Whimsy Journal, and today I wanted to do a show and tell of my Colonel Brandon. So this is the new Austin leather that was released, and I think there aren't very many review videos out right now, so just kind of wanted to show you what I got. In my order notes, I got the B6 slim size, and I asked for something with character. You don't always get what your order notes ask for, but I thought I'd give it a go, and I got this awesome sort of like pebbling effect. And from what I understand, this happens due to fat on the cow. So I think if you were to roll this, it would roll out all of this texture. So I won't be rolling this one, even though I sometimes like to roll my Darcy/Austin leathers. Just giving you a close-up look, I did get the stitching, but this is a classic, so there are no pockets. And I think this is a scar. This came with a notebook. This is a scratch, and these are scratches here. And I don't know if you could tell, a little bit of striation, but not too much on this side of it. But that is Colonel Brandon. So to give you a comparison, for those of us who've been collecting for a long time, this is a Pemberley fern. This one has patinaed too, so it's a little darker than it was originally, but this is it against some of our other green leathers that we know and love, the Titanic. And well, I guess both of these have patinaed by now. So it's a true olive. I think the Chic Spiro video showed it maybe a different shade, but this is showing up pretty true to color here. So, you know, and then of course there's always variation depending on what piece you get. So the inside, like I said, is a classic. I didn't get any pockets. It is showing up darker here. It doesn't show up that much darker in person. But maybe it's just this light because the light's very bright. But the inside is very, very smooth. Sometimes you can get a Austin/Darcy leather that is very rough on the inside. This one is particularly smooth. And just to give you a comparison of like different textures you may expect to get from a Darcy leather, I'll show you my Lady Catherine that I got last year. And she is so gorgeous. I'm so weird about my notebooks. I'm always like hit or miss when I get them. And mostly when I get them, it's miss. Like I don't like it at first. I really didn't like Lady Catherine at first, and then she grew on me, and now I absolutely love her. But what I'm trying to say is the texture on here, I'm used to getting Darcy's that are like more pristine. I think like when this came, it was a more pristine piece of leather. Like perfect, almost no flaws, maybe just striation. And then over time, you know, I weathered it down, if you will. This is also a second hand one. I got this off the buy sell trade site, and it was in pretty much pristine condition when I got it, but you know, as you use it, it wears. And what I'm trying to say is this one is very textured. So like in the back here especially, you can see is very ripply and rough, as opposed to this one that I got, which is very like, I don't know, like smooth and flat. So that's something you can expect in the range of Darcy leathers. I wonder, and I don't know, but I wonder if more of the classics do have this character, and they save more of the, like, I don't know, better, if you will, pieces for deluxe, because I don't think I've ever gotten a deluxe that had that much character in it. This is a personal size that my daughter marked up. I'm still trying to, like, figure out what to do with this. If you have tips on, like, how to take off ink or, like, maybe distress this in an artsy way, let me know, because I would still really like to use this. But as you can tell, I've never gotten a deluxe that had a whole lot of character as these two have. So I don't know. maybe if you want something with more character, maybe you're going to have better luck ordering a classic. Anywho, just wanted to do a little quick video because I know Colonel Brandon is pretty new and I'm sure people are a little bit on the fence. It's a different color than they've ever offered. And wanted to give you a true comparison. I am actually not a huge fan of this color to begin with, but I know just like Lady Catherine, this one is going to grow on me and it's probably going to end up being something that I would never think of giving away or selling. So I hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions, let me know. And if you're waiting for your Colonel Brandon in the mail, let me know. Alright everyone, I hope you're all staying safe out there and well, and have a wonderful rest of your weekend or week or whatever, because you could be watching this at any time, I just realized. Okay, take care and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!